Jesus Christ, Savior King. Jesus Christ, my everything. Christ, our King.
Jesus Christ, Messiah, Lord. Jesus Christ, my life's reward. Let's rejoice as we celebrate Christ, our King.
Good evening, FH Jenkins family and friends. We are so glad that you were able to join us tonight for this wonderful program as our scholars share with you that Jesus Christ was born. Yes, he was born for you and for me. And there are some wonderful special presentations just for you all as we get out this beautiful word to our community. A special thank you to our constituent churches who have agreed to play this program on their platforms, whether it be YouTube or Facebook. We really do appreciate your willingness to help us spread this message. Traditionally, we have an amazing Christmas musical that we do every year, but as you all know, we are in the midst of some trying times, and that is forcing us to do things a little bit differently this year. So thank you again for your support. Throughout this evening, you'll see pop up on the screen a call to action. A call to action to support F.H. Jenkins Preparatory School with your donation. F.H. Jenkins is a kindergarten through 10th grade institution that is dedicated to inspiring leaders and cultivating excellence. So we encourage you, we implore you to please support this school as we move forward with this mighty mission. Coming up, you're going to see a video that outlines and explains some of the work we do at FH Jenkins. We have a great calling, and the faculty and staff and alumni all are rallying to make sure that we continue to provide amazing, excellent education for our scholars year after year. So you'll hear a little bit more about FH Jenkins coming up, and then you'll get a special welcome from two of our high school students, Mackenzie and Cameron. We hope you enjoy this evening. Share this link, invite someone to join you as we enjoy and spread the good news that Christ was born for you and for me. FH Jenkins is committed to inspiring leaders and cultivating excellence. So what we do every day, from the time our scholars arrive to the time our last teacher leaves the building, is we are committed and dedicated to ensuring that every scholar is being equipped with the academics, with the spiritual fortitude, with the emotional support that they need in order to make an indelible impact on the world. That is why this school exists, so that we can build courageous Christian leaders who are ready to go out of these halls and into the community and make a difference.
I like FH Jenkins because it's an environment where I can just be myself and I can connect with other people because they look like me and they have the same beliefs as me and they do the same things as me. And I feel like I can be a part of a community that acts and does the same things I do instead of being a part of an area or in an area where I'm different from everybody else and everybody judges you because of the color of your skin or how you act or what you believe in.
I would say that it took some convincing to know that FH Jenkins was the place to start with our son in pre-K-3. After his year and just seeing how he loved going to school, he would always say that, you know, he missed school and he wanted to go to school. So when a child starts saying that, then you have to know that there's something special going on there. So he has been with this school all that time, pre-K three to seventh grade. Our daughter followed in his footsteps. And so we have been pleased with the things that they have experienced to have our children in education where they are getting Jesus every day, and they are growing and maturing, and they have lifelong friends.
Well, for me, I totally believe in the outlook of FH Jenkins in building young, Christian, Black children to their highest potential.
We strongly believe, and we strongly communicate to our students, that that does not begin when they become adults. It begins now. So as a part of our program, we include community service and opportunities for students to serve others. It's not just about what we can give them, but it's about how we prepare them to give to others.
Since I've been at FH Jenkins, I've had the opportunity to see so many students grow in so many wonderful ways. It's not just the school, it's the community, and I am so blessed to be a part of the community.
I have sent my kids here, and I now see them lead out in many different aspects of their lives, including here at school. And you want to make sure that you are not just rearing followers, but you are rearing kids or children who are leaders.
If you are looking for a place to send your scholar, please do not overlook the school by the mighty Cumberland River, F.H. Jenkins Preparatory School.
Welcome to FH Jenkins Virtual Christmas Program. Back up. We're gonna be doing things a little bit differently this year. Can I get 6 feet, please?
Whew, that's better. Welcome to FH Jenkins Virtual Christmas Program.
As you can tell, we're having to do things a little bit differently this year.
Each year we put on a huge production. It really is the highlight of the year.
It really is, Cameron, but FHJ Prep is still going to take time to celebrate the King of Kings.
We know this isn't the exact time Jesus was born, but we want to be able to shine a light on our Savior any chance we can get.
So sit back, relax, and celebrate the Savior with us.
Christ, the Almighty Savior, is the light of the world, born in Bethlehem to redeem God's people.
Imagine a journey on a donkey for miles.
To get to the census through the desert of trials.
The final location, Bethlehem, to be counted.
That's the beginning of the trouble that mountain.
Mary was carrying a baby inside.
And Joseph was worried about the difficult ride.
They hopped on a donkey, their journey began.
Despite their concern, they still followed the plan.
Crossing the desert, they traveled along,
praying that nothing at all will go wrong.
In the city of David, they arrived through God's grace.
But then soon discovered a distinct lack of space.
Too many people were there by decree.
So Mary and Joseph had nowhere to be.
They searched high and low for a good place to stop.
But all inns were full, right up to the top.
God spells with them, he found them a spot.
It wasn't a rich, no room service or a cot.
Not even a place
in a hotel at all.
A lonely old stable, little more than a stall.
No matter the shelter, a miracle that night.
Baby Jesus was born, the world's shining bright light.
How would God herald the birth of the King?
A host of his angels would show up and sing.
To shepherds who tend to their field in the night.
Invited by God to come see the great sight.
And then in the sky there shone a bright star.
Guiding the wise men who came from afar.
So imagine, if you will, what a miracle God made.
From a dangerous journey by a couple of freight.
Do you understand what he used for birth?
Of a baby, his son, that would save the whole earth.
Now, picture how God can use someone like me.
Small, but with God's help, strong as cookie.
And he can use you to do great things, no doubt.
Because miracle making is what God is all about.
Thank you so much to our FH Jenkins scholars. What a powerful presentation. You know, I must say that I think that we often take for granted how arduous a journey that must have been for Mary and Joseph as they went to such a lowly place to bear the Savior of the world. Oh, but let me tell you something. The beauty in it all, though it may have started in such a lowly place, please believe that Jesus is coming back and he is going to take us to a place with such glory we've never seen, to be in his presence, to walk on streets of gold, and to live in the beautiful mansions that he has prepared for us. Oh, my brothers and sisters, I hope you all know that that day is truly coming. Won't you be ready? Thank you again to our scholars for that beautiful presentation of that poem and the amazing reminder that Christ came just for us. I want to take a special moment to thank our faculty, our staff, for all of the hard work that they have been doing. Consistently, they have been providing excellent education and services to our families and to our scholars, and we should never take that for granted. This has been such a, I don't even know how to describe it. What a year it's been to be teaching in the midst of a pandemic and running a school in the midst of a pandemic. We want to make sure that our teachers know and understand we love them and we appreciate the excellent work that they have been doing throughout this time. I'm just gonna give a quick little plug here because I really want you guys to understand how great our teachers are doing. In the midst of a pandemic, do you understand that our test scores are still going up? Yes, we just reviewed the data a few weeks ago and our scholars are still striving and performing. Thank you to our faculty and staff for all they do to make sure that our scholars are continuing to grow. Thank you to the families who right now are partnering with us to make sure that that happens. FH Jenkins means a lot to a lot of people. And we want to make sure that we continue to provide excellence all along the way. Thank you to our local pastors here who have been supporting us through prayer, through advice, through teaching, through so much here at FH Jenkins. We truly appreciate you. What you're gonna hear in just a moment is you're gonna hear from one of our pastors, Pastor Marlon Reed, as he explains what FH Jenkins means to him as both a pastor and a parent.
Hi, my name is Marlon Reed, and I just wanna share with you three reasons why I love FHJ. Actually, there are a whole lot, but I'll just narrow it down to three. The first thing that I love about FH Jenkins is that their commitment to academic excellence. Not only do they set a high bar, but they come alongside every child and help them reach their potential and they hold them accountable. The second reason is their adaptability. As you know, 2020 has been a crazy year, but they have adapted to all of the things that have happened and done it with great thoughtfulness and wisdom, and I praise God for them. And the last reason is that they are not only committed to the academic excellence of the child, but they're also committed to the spiritual growth and development. Just a couple weeks ago, I've had a couple of baptisms of some of the young people here from FHJ, and when I looked out into our social distance congregation, there were all of the teachers there in support of each student. And so I praise God for that. It reminded me of this village that we have and that this partnership that we have to help lead children to a deeper faith in Jesus Christ. That's why I love FHJ.
And now, a special selection from a first grade FHJ scholar, Carter Hammonds.
My name is Courtney Campbell, and I am connected to FH Jenkins in three different ways. I am a teacher of the middle school, I am a parent of a kindergarten student, and I am a proud alumnus of FH Jenkins. Since I've been at FH Jenkins, I've had the opportunity to see so many students grow in so many wonderful ways. It's not just the school, it's the community, and I am so blessed to be a part of this community. When my child became of school age, I could not think of any place better than FH Jenkins, and not just because I work here. Even before I worked here, I knew exactly where I wanted my child to go to continue the legacy of all the Campbells and even the Edmonds who have graduated from FH Jenkins. We are all so proud to be associated with a school with such a wonderful legacy and such a wonderful history that still manages to make sure that it is in tune with what's happening in the present. I cannot imagine a better location for my child. I can't imagine a better place for me to work and grow. And as an alumnus, I am just so proud of the progress that has been made here at FH Jenkins. If you are looking for a school, if you are looking for a family, if you are looking for a place for your child to feel safe, loved, and be able to learn at a very rapid rate and be able to learn so many different things, there is not one place that can offer you all of those things all in one wonderful, blessed location. There's no place better for that than FH Jenkins.
Hear the angels singing?
Can you hear the church bells ringing?
Can you guess who all this is for?
It's for the birth of Jesus, our Lord.
Do you hear what I hear? Do you hear what I hear?
Do you hear what I hear? Do you hear what I hear?
Do you hear what I hear? Do you hear what I hear?
Do you hear what I hear? Do you hear what I hear?
Do you hear what I hear?
Do you hear what I hear?
Do you hear what I hear? Do you hear what I hear?
Do you hear what I hear? Do you hear what I hear?
Do you hear what I hear? Do you hear what I hear?
Set the night wind to the little lamb. Do you see what I see? Way up in the sky, little lamb. Do you see what I see? A star, dancing in the night with a tail as big as a kite. With a tail as big as a kite.
Shepherd boy,
do you hear what I hear?
Do you hear what I hear?
Running through the sky, shepherd boy,
do you hear what I hear?
Do you hear what I hear? A song, high above the trees, with a voice as big as the sea.
The shepherd boy to the mighty king.
Do you know what I know?
In your palace warm, mighty king.
Do you know what I know?
A child, shivers in the cold. Let us bring him silver and gold.
What I see.
He will bring us goodness and light. He will bring us goodness and light.
My name is Christian Chun. I am a student at FH Jenkins and I am in 10th grade. My experience in high school at FH Jenkins has been a very comfortable one. It's better than other schools. I know that before I have toured other high schools and other schools in general, even in 8th grade, not in high school, I've been to other public schools and other private schools, and none of them have really suited myself. I have not been able to find as great of teachers as I found at FH Jenkins, who can help me and understand me, who more so take time to explain to you, help you out, get what you need to get done. I have not found that at many other schools as I have at FH Jenkins. It's more comfortable and it's more of an enclosed community. And moving from eighth grade to high school, I thought it was gonna be a rough transition. But as I went through it, I've noticed that it is much easier. And especially with the help of the teachers and getting along with the classmates, I'd say I've learned and gone farther than I could have at, I believe, any other school.
Sweet baby Jesus, born of the Virgin Mary, needs Bethlehem star.
Storm.
Again for joining us this evening. I pray that you were richly blessed. Thank you to our families for all of your support as we pulled this program together. Thank you to the faculty and staff who helped to make this happen. Thank you for all of your support throughout this program through your donations. We truly appreciate you. I ask and I challenge you that you share this program with someone else. Go ahead, copy the link, send it in an email, send it via text, share it on your Facebook pages. However you would like to share it, we do ask you to share this presentation with others. We want this message that Christ is born, that He is our Savior, to go as far as it possibly can around the world. That's what we're called to do, to share the gospel, the good news with the world. So would you help us do that? We appreciate you for all that you do. We thank you for joining us and have a great evening.